Good afternoon. The first item of business is time for reflection. And our time for reflection leader today is Reverend Kenneth McKenzie, Minister of the Parish of Braemar and Crathy and Domestic Chaplain to His Majesty the King.
Presiding Officer, members of the Scottish Parliament, good afternoon. In a place where rhetoric matters, let me crave your indulgence by asking a question which is not as rhetorical nor as grammatically correct as some might prefer. What does it feel like to be prayed for? I ask this of you who have been elected to the Scottish Parliament because even in this month of May, in the year of our Lord 2023, a month during which another group of nationwide representatives will assemble as you first did in an historic hall just up this street, I cannot think of another Scottish body that will be more often the subject of prayer than this Honourable House. What does it feel like to be prayed for? This is not the first time that I have asked this question, but being by nature and nurture a Highlander and still identifying as an Invernessian, the last time I dropped this question, I reverted to the Queen's English. In fact, in true Highland style, I didn't so much drop the question as drop the question mark. 2 weeks ago, at the door of Crathy Kirk, I took the liberty of asking one of our congregants, of assuring one of our congregants, that on the day of his upcoming coronation, he would almost certainly be the most prayed for person in all of Christendom. Like his mother before him, he seemed rather moved by such a declaration. In his much remarked upon book, Religion for Atheists, a Non-Believer's Guide to the Uses of Religion, Alan de Botton reflects on the fact that in every flourishing culture and society, there has always been room for symbolism and for ceremony. He, naturally enough, bemoans the fact that in nearly all instances, ceremony and symbolism seem so intrinsically bound to faith and belief. I, some might suggest, naturally enough, am not at all surprised that this should be the case. As we preachers and parliamentarians know only too well, there are times when words, ordinary words, are not enough. In times of trouble or triumph, on the occasion of appointment or disappointment, words matter, but they are not enough. It is in part through ceremony and symbolism, it is in part through prayer, that we mere mortals allow room for mystery and for meaning. Blessed are those who know what it is to be kept in the prayers of a nation. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Reverend McKenzie.